Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we do some more computations with numbers using scientific notation, and we do these following division problems, writing our answers in scientific notation. All right, we're going to do some computations, division in particular, and use scientific notation. So we're going to have to remember these laws of exponents right here. B to the m times b to the n is b to the m plus n, and b to the m over b to the n equals b to the m minus n. All right, so here's our first example. 1.6 times 10 to the seventh over or divided by 8 times 10 squared. So what I could do is take the number part and divide. So I could do the 1.6 over 8 and then do times the 10. Now, actually, skipping a step here, times 10 to the 7th over 10 squared. So we can do 1.6 divided by 8. Now you could use your calculator, but this is pretty easy to do without a calculator. That's 16 divided by 8, basically, which is 2, and then you have to go in one place for the decimal point. So we have 0.2 times, now we have 10 to the 7th divided by 10 squared, so we have to subtract exponents. So 7 minus 2, write that out. Okay, now we have to go a little bit further. All right, now 0.2 is not in scientific notation, so let's rewrite that in scientific notation. Remember, it has to be a number between 1 and 10, and so there has to be a single digit before the decimal point. So we would write that as 2 times what? 10 to the, you'd have to move it one place to the left, negative 1. So 0.2 is 2 times 10 to the negative 1. This number over here is 10 to the fifth. So we're almost there. 2 times 10 to the, all right, 10 to the negative 1 times 10 to the fifth. Now you have the same issue, add exponents. Negative 1 plus 5 is 4. So now we've written our answer in scientific notation. Now, what if we wanted to write that number in standard form? That would be a 2 with 4 zeros. Okay, so 2 times 10 to the fourth is the same thing as 20,000. Now, the reason we often put in scientific notation is because our answer might be too big or too small. In this case, it was easy to write out 20,000, but if it was 2 to the 40th, then of course you wouldn't want to have to sit there and write down 40 zeros in a row. All right, here's another problem. 55 times 10 to the 12th over 1.1 times 10 squared. Now you might notice the numerator is not even in scientific notation, but that's okay. We could put in scientific notation, but you don't need to. So again, we could just split this up a little since it's all times and write that 55 over 1.1 times, and then write our 10 to the 12th over 10 squared. By the way, I'm showing you one way to do this problem. This is not the only way to get the answer. Okay, now you have to do 55 divided by 1.1. You could do that in your calculator and see what you get. Let me tell you how I like to do it. I don't like to divide by 1.1. I don't really like using my calculator. So when I see 55 over 1.1, I'm just going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 10, which means in the numerator I have 55 times 10. And in the denominator, why I multiplied it by 10 is so that this became a whole number, 11. And then I could just go 11 into 55. Goes 5. 5 times 10 is 50. Did you get 50 by using your calculator? That's fine. I like to practice my arithmetic. All right, so calculator, or you could do it any other way. You could do long division, 1.1 into 55, put your zero here, move your little decimal place over. We all learn different ways to do division with decimals. So three ways: calculator, making the denominator a whole number, long division. Okay, in any case, 55 divided by 1.1 is 50. Now, what about over here? We have 10 to the 12th over 10 squared divided by. So we're going to have to go times 10 to the what? Well, you subtract exponents. That's 10 to the 10th. But this is not in scientific notation, and you were asked to write it in scientific notation. So now I have to deal with this 50. 50 is 5 times 10 to the first, correct? Then I have times this 10 to the 10th. So we're almost there. So 5, now that's the number between 1 and 10, times 10 to the, now you add the exponents, to the 11th. Like I said, one way to get the answer. Now, if you were going to write this in standard form, you would have 5 with 11 zeros after it, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. As you can see, this is a very big number. All right, here's our next example. See if you could try this on your own. We want to write our answer in scientific notation. Okay, so again, we could kind of split it up. Now, you could probably do this in your head. 180 divided by 2. Go ahead, just cancel. And that's going to give you 90, right? Okay, so I'm going to get 90 times 10 to the, all right, we got to subtract. Be very careful here. It's a negative 15 and subtract 5. Now, I'm also noticing since I want to put this in scientific notation, I want to rewrite 90 in scientific notation. So that's 9 times 10 to the first again, just like in the last problem. And this is 10 to the, what's negative 15 minus 5? Negative 20. So I have 9 times 10 to the, right, now we add exponents, right? We're using that law of exponents. So 1 minus 20 is negative 19. And there's our answer written in scientific notation. I'm not going to write that out the long way. It'd be a lot of zeros before the decimal point. Or I should say after the de see. After the decimal point, there's a bunch of zeros before you get to that 9. Okay, let's try another problem. Okay, here's our next problem. So we've got 5 divided by 200 times 10 to the 13th over 10 to the negative 11. So you can use your calculator to do 5 divided by 200, and that is 0.025. And then I'm going to use my law of exponents here. Same base, you subtract the exponent. So I have a 13 minus what's at the bottom. So minus a negative 11 is 13 plus positive 11. Are we okay with that? Remember, if it's a negative 11 in the denominator, positive 11 in the numerator. So this isn't quite in scientific notation because of this 0.025, so I want to rewrite 0.025 in scientific notation. So that's 2.5 times 10 to the negative 2, right, because it's really a smaller number, times 10 to the 24th. Adding my exponents. So this gives me 2.5 times 10 to the 22nd. Right, by the way, this is how I do 5 divided by 200. When I have leading zeros in the denominator, I divide the top and bottom by 100. So I move the decimal 2 to the left for both of those. So watch. If I divide this 2 to the left and I move this 2 to the left, that I think of as 0.05 divided by 2. And that's an easy thing to do with long division. So then I just say put an extra zero here. 2 goes into 50, 25. But of course, if you have your calculator, that works as well. I like to practice doing things just using my knowledge of fractions and decimals, etc. So we've done a lot of problems. We've learned how to write numbers in scientific notation, how to take numbers that are in scientific notation, write as decimal numbers, multiply numbers using scientific notation, and divide numbers using scientific notation. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.